I should like to congratulate you, Dr. Hans Kruger, on your appointment as Regional Director for Europe for the period of 5 years from 1st February 2020, and to convey our best wishes for your success in all your endeavor in the region. Dr. Kruger, may I invite you to come forward. Thank you, Dr. Kruger, to come forward. I shall now invite Dr. Hans Kruger to stand up again and take the oath of office.
Yes. I solemnly swear to exercise in all loyalty, discretion, and conscience the functions entrusted to me as an international civil servant of the World Health Organization, to discharge those functions and regulate my conduct with the interest of the World Health Organization only in view, and not to seek or accept instructions in regard to the performance of my duties from any government or other authority external to the organization.
Thank you. Now, oath and offer of appointment are signed. May I invite you, Dr. Hans Kruger, to say a few words. The floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Dr. Natali, the chair of the executive board, and my previous ADG of HIV and TB. Dear executive members, ladies and gentlemen, this is definitely a high day in my professional career to serve the people. I would like to warmly thank all the members of the Executive Board for confirming my nomination by the European Member States, and I would like to assure you that I see this confidence as a sign of trust, but also as a political responsibility to fulfill my engagement to you, the Member States, in transparency and accountability for the next 5 years. I would like to assure my big brother, Dr. Tedros, for my full support to your global vision, the GPW, as a one WHO and a one United Nations family to deliver upon the triple billion goals at country level. In this global context, the WHO Regional Office for Europe will work with each of the 53 European member states, whether small or large, West, Central, or East, to improve the health and well-being of the people according to each country-specific and sub-regional context. I also would like to assure my five peers, WHO region directors from the five other regions, of my very strong desire to work together and, in all modesty, to learn from the experiences from all your member states. I always say, every country in the world can share health and health system innovations with each other. I definitely would like to very warmly thank the government of my country, the Kingdom of Belgium, for an extraordinary support that I received and which allowed me to go and dialogue with each of the 53 countries, with the Minister of Health and Foreign Affairs, the Belgian government, which is today represented by His Excellency, the Ambassador Geert Muilen, and Mr. Tom Owers, the Secretary General of the Minister of Health of Belgium. Similarly, it would not have been possible for me to stand here in front of you and also to stay healthy without my exceptional private campaign team, represented today by both my parents who are in the room, with Katerina, Anastasia and Sofia. With Katerina, Anastasia and Sofia watching at home. My parents, in fact, who taught my sister Adelheid and me from very early age the human right to health and the values of dignity and respect, and who have always treated the poor patients and religious leaders free of charge in their private medical clinic. I would like to express appreciation to the three region directors in Euro that I had really the opportunity to work with, Dr. Marc Danzon, who has been a great compagnon de route during my campaign, Dr. Susanna Jakab for taking me to the director team, and Dr. Piroshka Ostlin, who gave me the space to come in with the transition team and to prepare for this day today so I can hit the ground running. I also know that I can count on the loyalty and dedication of all the staff at the regional office in Europe, and in return, I commit to support them with organizational development to operationalize the United Nations Workplace Strategy on Mental Health and Well-being, to create a culture of open communication, and to be a leader who will never close the eyes to any form of harassment, be it bullying or sexual harassment of female consultants in the office. My program, my vision is called EPW, European Program of Work, EPW to support the GPW, with the motto of my campaign, United Action for Better Health. United, because for me, partnership is an ethical duty. Action, because country after country during my European campaign marathon asked WHO to move from the what to the how, from the paper to the country action. And health, because I have an integrated vision of health, of clinical curative care, with the essential public health functions, putting the people and the health workers in the center around a strong primary health care center to move towards universal health coverage within the SDGs. Europe faces enormous challenges, and we know that the road is long and the mountain is steep. But I have been impressed by the European solidarity during my campaign. And when the going gets tough, those who know me, I fall back on what I learned during the two of the best years of my life working in the prisons in Siberia. Дорогу усилит идущий, потому что надежда умирает
последняя.
She who climbs the mountain will master the road, because hope dies the last. Спасибо вам большое. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Adi Yulo. I shall now give the floor to the Director General.
Спасибо большое, Hans. Хорошо.
Хорошо, молодец.
Hans, my dear brother, first of all, I would like to say congratulations on your appointment as WHO Director General for Europe. Your resounding election success is a clear indication that you have earned the confidence and trust of member states across the European region. I have the deepest respect for how you conducted your campaign, visiting countries, engaging with patients and with presidents, and listening to their needs and challenges. As you said, it was quite a marathon. With modesty and determination, you gained an understanding of the concerns of people in Europe and opened doors at the highest political levels to put health firmly on the agenda. Your way of working is my way of working. In every position you have held and every health challenge that you have faced, you have thought to protect and promote the health needs of the most vulnerable. In you, the member states of the European region have a leader who embodies the values of the organization, a trusted public servant, committed to the excellence in health, working through collaboration and caring deeply about people. An insightful profile in The Lancet, published recently, describes you as an idealist, but you have that rare combination of qualities, idealism coupled with the resolve to see your ideas through, to make them happen. This is what our organization needs, and it's what the people of the European region deserve. I'm gratified that your vision for the European region builds on WHO's global priorities to achieve universal health coverage, address health emergencies, and promote healthier populations. And I look forward to advancing the European program of work, United Action for Better Health, with you. You have inherited a regional office in an enviably strong position, of course, a network of dynamic country offices, programmatic work that leads the world in many ways, including on addressing the health of refugees and migrants and tackling antimicrobial resistance, and a team of highly motivated staff. Dear Hans, welcome to your new position in WHO. It's well deserved. You can count on my unwavering support to take your vision forward. Together, we will deliver results to the place we serve, to the people we serve. I will repeat this, sorry. Together, we will deliver results to the people we serve. And I know your energy, so we will do it together. Together.
Thank you, DG. Now, I think we have a photo session. Photo opportunities.
I learned a lot from you.
Yes, no. Every success.
Thank you very much.